it was proposed to have a business district by the name Startup Area Project within the proposed Amaravathi city in Andhra Pradesh by the erstwhile government. It was proposed to develop the startup area consisting of about 1691 acres, that is roughly you can say 1700 acres, by a company called Amaravathi Development Partners Private Limited, ADP Private Limited, which in turn consisted of a few Singapore companies, namely Ascenda Singbridge, which now has become Capital Lands, and Semcorp. This is called the Singapore Consortium, and Amaravathi Development Corporation belonging to the government of Andhra Pradesh. It was proposed to have this company in the equity ratio of 58% Singapore Consortium and 42% the Amaravathi Development Corporation. After deliberations and discussions between the Amaravathi Development Corporation and Singapore Consortium, it was decided to close this project. During the deliberations, it was realized that this 1700 acres is actually a small part of the big huge city that was proposed to be developed. The huge city along with the area around it, which comprises of the CRDA, is about 217 square kilometers, which is roughly I think maybe about two times the size of Mumbai, including Navi Mumbai and the suburbs. Within this CRDA, there again is a proposed city called Amaravathi, which again is roughly about 1 lakh acres. This 1 lakh acres was proposed to be acquired by way of about 35,000 acres of land, fertile agricultural land belonging to various owners by way of land pooling, about 10,000 acres of government land. It was also proposed to acquire about 40,000 acres of forest land by deforesting the existing forest, for which the government of Andhra Pradesh had requested, the then government of India, the then government of Andhra Pradesh had requested for permission to deforest. So this roughly is about 1 lakh acres. This is called the Amaravathi city, which is a part of the CRDA, which is about 217 square kilometers. And this is about 1700 acres within that 1 lakh acres. So during deliberations, it was realized that it requires about 1.5-2 crores of money to develop that 1 lakh acres. So which itself amounts to about roughly 2 lakh crores, which is about the size of the Andhra Pradesh state budget for an entire year. And unless the 2 lakh crores is spent and unless that 1 lakh acres is developed, then there is no meaning in having a business district within that huge city that was proposed, which by common sense makes us understand that this is a huge process which takes decades and decades and which cannot be done in a span of 5 years or 10 years. Neither is the time permissible, nor does the finances of any state for that matter or any country permits this sort of development in such a short span. And the government of Andhra Pradesh right now also has taken into account and realized the importance of various other requirements of the state today, like infrastructure development, on health, on education, on development of industries, on development of industrial estates, on providing education as well as employment opportunities to our youth, who are graduating every year, as well as the holistic development and the comprehensive development of the entire state consisting of 13 districts. So in this scenario, it was realized that the development of that 1700 acres alone in this huge big gambit is not as easy as was thought of or envisaged by the erstwhile government, which is an, morally you can say, an impossible task. So that is how this company, it was decided to wind up this company. So this is in the best interest, and at the same time, the Singapore companies which are represented by their Ministry of Trade and Industry Singapore have released a press note where it says, in this instance, the Singapore consortium companies have stated that the project has cost them, and its closure does not impact their investment plans in India. It does not impact their investment plans in India. Singapore companies remain interested in opportunities in Andhra Pradesh and other Indian states because of the size and potential of the market. Our economic agencies will continue to help our companies internationalize by exploring opportunities in India and other overseas markets. So they very clearly stated that they will remain to be interested in investment opportunities in various sectors, and during the discussions it was also broadly decided that their investment and their technical expertise is very much invited in Andhra Pradesh too, in the form of development of various urban centers, infrastructure in various urban centers, infrastructure part of smart cities, aquaculture, industrial estates and industries themselves in the core sector, as well as development of ports. This was all discussed, and this will be taken up further by both the government of Andhra Pradesh as well as the Ministry of Trade Singapore. So this is where we stand today, and they also are very keen and very interested in areas of skill development, areas of education, areas where technical expertise as well as financial strength is required for development of ports and industrial estates.
ఈ వీడియో నచ్చితే ఓ లైక్ కొట్టండి, లేకపోతే కామెంట్ చేయండి, బట్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి.